Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Rami Nsour, and this is my recording for MCC's nightly Quran reminders during Ramadan of 2020. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making this the best Ramadan for you and your family, and making these last 10 nights that we are in right now the best of your Ramadan. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Last week, I was finishing up some of the discussion about the pattern of the Quran and how some of what is mentioned at the end of the Quran at the beginning of the Quran is reflected in the last surah. So those last surahs in the Quran, especially starting on chapter 90 on down, reflect a lot of the lessons that are found in the beginning of the Quran in the longer surahs. Now, one thing we have to remember is that when we look at the Quran, we should not ever judge a surah or an ayah based on its length. And this is something that Imam Al-Ghazali points out in his amazing book called Jewels of the Quran. I encourage you to purchase that book and go through it. But he says, don't be deluded by thinking that the importance of a surah or an ayah is by the length or about how many words are in that. That's not what's intended. And so for the majority of Muslims who are not going to memorize the entire Quran, or at least aren't going to be able to read through the Quran on a regular basis, you can rest assured that you can get all of the lessons from the longer surahs in that last section of the Quran, namely the last juz, but even the last from 90, the last 20 or so surahs of the Quran, you can get so much out of just those surahs. And so, especially in these last 10 nights of Ramadan, if we're not able to do a khatam all the time, even and throughout the year as well, if we're not able to recite the Quran regularly, which we should be doing, but if we're not able to do that, let's at least familiarize ourselves with those last surahs of the Quran, know what they mean, know what the stories are behind them, so that we can get those lessons. And so to emphasize how important those last surahs are, I want to turn to a discussion about the chronological order of the Quran. Now, we know that the Quran, as we recite it now, starting with Fatiha and then Surah Al-Baqarah all the way down, is not the way it was revealed. That was the way that, of course, was the final intention of how the order of those surahs should be, but it's not the way that they actually came down. And so what is the order of how they came down? And this will help us understand even the lessons that are in those surahs, how to pair them up with events that happened during the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and even see some of the themes. So one of the things, for example, that we'll see is that at the beginning of the revelation, the surahs are talking about tawheed, about the oneness of Allah, and about general good character, characteristics that we should have. Feeding the hungry, taking care of the orphan, and so forth. It's in the later surahs that actually a lot of the laws come down. Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Nur, Surah Al-Talaq, Surah Al-Tahrim, and so forth. And those main surahs up at the front of the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, Ali Imran, An-Nisa, that have a lot of the rules of Islam, were actually revealed later during the Medinan period of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's life, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, some of the scholars, like Imam al-Suyuti, says that Imam Ali, radiallahu anhu, actually has his mushaf was in the chronological order, was listed in the order of how the surahs are revealed. If you look online, chronological order of the Quran, you can find some of these lists. But one thing to remember is that Imam al-Suyuti mentions, he says it's not, we cannot say for a fact what is the order of the surahs. There's a lot of research that has been done. There's approximations on the order. And we know we have a good general idea and even to some details of the order of the revelation of the Quran. But we can't say for sure, for 100% fact, that this is the way it was ordered. But with that said, Imam Suyuti does have a listing. And not only does he have a listing, but he also has an entire book. And it's been translated into English, and I encourage you to purchase this book and add it to your home library for you and your family, your children to read through. It's called Secrets Within the Order of the Quran by Jalaluddin al-Suyuti. And not only does he list out the the order of the Quran, but he also goes through some of the secrets in the final ordering of the Quran. So let's just take a few minutes to look at each of those. One of the things that we'll see is that in the beginning of the message, the surahs that are mentioned, look at this. Surah Al-Alaq, of course. Iqra' bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. We know that. Surah Al-Qalam, Surah Al-Muzammil, and Surah Al-Mudathir, and Al-Fatiha. Now these five surahs, so Alaq, Qalam, Muzammil, Mudathir, and Al-Fatiha, these five surahs, take note, these were the only surahs that were mentioned for about the first 3 years of Islam. So for the first 3 years of Islam, that's all the Muslims had to recite, and they're reciting that over and over again. So what secrets are in those surahs? What secrets? We know the Fatiha actually contains the entire message of the Quran in the Fatiha, and that no other ummah was given that, so that something like the Fatiha. So that should motivate us even more to make sure that we know, at least for the Fatiha, every single letter. If we're just reciting it from memory, but we don't know what every single thing it means, let's take these last 10 nights of Ramadan to go back and say, okay, at least the bare minimum of what each one of those words mean, I want to know what those words mean. Then after 3 years, then we get Surah Al-Masad. But in the first, and Imam Suyuti breaks it into, and some of the listings into basically four periods, three being Meccan, beginning Meccan, middle Meccan, and late Meccan, and then the Medinan surahs. But if we just look at the first Meccan surahs, we have Surah then Masad, because that was or Tabbat Yada Abi Lahab wa Tab. That's when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was ordered to take the message now publicly. Abu Lahab cursed him, and the response was Surah Al-Masad. Then we have Takwir, Surah Al-A'la, Surah Al-Layl, Al-Fajr, Al-Duha, Al-Inshirah, Al-Asr, Al-Adiyat, Al-Kawthar, Al-Takathur, Al-Ma'un, Al-Kafirun. You can hear as I'm naming all of these are all those short surahs at the end of the Quran. These are the surahs that we recite in our prayers every single day. But one of the things that we'll see is that these surahs that were really the bulk of the surahs for the majority of the first third of that period of the Meccan period, they're those surahs. Al-Ma'un, Kafirun, Surah Al-Fil, Al-Falaq, An-Nas, and then Ikhlas. And then starts the second section. But if we just look at that those last, and it's really even just from Surah about 96, 90 and 96 on down, those surahs are what we should be reciting in our prayers. But not only should we be reciting them in our prayers, let's become more familiar with those surahs. Let's become familiar with the lessons. Let's reflect on those lessons. Let's not just speed through them during the recitation of our prayers. Let's reflect on them, because in those surahs are the message of Islam. You don't have to, it's great to study the entirety of the Quran, and that's what's intended. But let's not, if we're, like the Arabic saying is, من لا يقدر على الكل لا يترك الجل. If you're not able to do everything, well then don't leave most of it. You know, even if you can do just a little bit, do that. And if you can do that, your reflections and your reading, and even your reading of the tafsir of those ayahs, that's you can get a lot from that. Now, I want to turn to Imam Suyuti's book. And again, this is the Imam Suyuti's book, which is called Secrets Within the Order of the Quran. It's available in English, also available online in Arabic. And towards the end, since we're talking about that, Imam Suyuti mentions in this book, he says, this is a subject, like looking at the particular order of the Quran, and what are some of the secrets that we find in the ordering of the Quran. He said before him writing this book, he never found anything, any subject, any book that was written on this particular subject. He said he found a little bit mention here and there in some of the other earlier Mufassirin, but nothing taking it as an entire subject. And the majority of what he writes And some of the reflections that he have, he says, this is from my istinbath. This is just from my own personal reflections. And what I think is so powerful about that is that this is also should be an encouragement to you to look at the Quran and to try to, you know, to uncover some of the secrets or why are certain surahs in certain mentioned in certain ways. So to give one example, and we'll just go to right to the end. He says, if we look at surah of Al-Kafirun. Now, Al-Kafirun was revealed because the kuffar came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They said, at first they were telling him, don't preach Islam. Then they were saying, okay, if you're going to preach Islam, you know, we'll worship your Lord one day, one year, our Lord one year. No, 1 month, 1 month. No, 1 week, 1 week. One day, one day. No, we're not going to do that. And so the response to that was, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ. Say to the disbelievers, and then it mentions that. Now, then right after that comes Surah An-Nasr, and Imam Suyuti says, well, what's the connection between having Surah An-Nasr right after Surah Al-Kafirun? He said, the answer, it's as if that if you look at Surah Al-Kafirun as a response to the kuffar who said, worship our religion and your religion, and we say, no, we're not going to worship your religion, then the response is, okay, what do I get? إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ فَالْفَتْحِ. You get the victory. For those who have this firm steadfastness and reject kufr, you get a nasr. And then the response is, well, what about the people who don't accept that? تَبَّتْ يَدَا أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبْ. So we have these two surahs right after قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكَافِرُونَ. Here's the stance. لا أعبد ما تعبدون. I don't worship what you worship. You don't worship what I worship. Okay, so we have two parties. Deen of Islam and other than that. If you respond, you get victory. If you don't, you get تَبَّتْ يَدَا أَبِي لَهَبٍ وَتَبْ. The same thing that he got. And it doesn't matter how close you are in relation to the Prophet ﷺ. Because remember, Abu Lahab was his uncle. And did not save him. And then Imam Suyuti says, and he mentions other examples of why the surahs are in this order. And then comes Surah Al-Ikhlas. And he says what he finds as a connection between this is actually a response to قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ. So when in Surah Al-Kafirun it says, I don't worship what you worship, and you don't worship what I worship, well, the question might come, well, what is it that you worship? قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ. So you can see all of these connections between those surahs. And of course, this is just a short reminder, and it's not going to go into a deep lesson. But you can pick up this book and look through some of these, and then start searching yourself for some of the connections that might be there. Because these are not something that's a definite. We know exactly why it is. We're just trying to understand why is the Quran in this order. For example, if you take Surah Al-Fil, Surah Al-Fil is about the destruction of the army of Abraha and how he was trying to destroy the Kaaba. And at the end it says, كَعَصْفٍ مَّأْكُولٍ. Then we have made them like crushed straw. And if you read it directly connected to the next surah, it says, كَعَصْفٍ مَّأْكُولٍ لِإِلَافِ قُرَيْشِ. For the benefit or for the sake of Quraysh. So it actually the meaning of those surahs actually completed itself. So here we are, Ya Quraysh. Remember, لَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِأَصْحَابِ الْفِيلِ. Do you not see how what you did with what we did with the elephants? And we destroyed them for you, لِإِلَافِ قُرَيْشِ. For your and the same thing happens with other surahs as well. Imam Suyuti goes through this. The more we learn about the Quran, the more we see the miracles and the beauty of the Quran, the closer we will be to it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring us closer to the Quran during this month of Ramadan, during these last 10 days. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us close to the Quran for the remainder of the year. Please keep us in your dua. I know some people who are in the hospital right now. One person who just got out because of COVID. I know other people, families who are suffering. There's people who have lost family members. So keep them in your dua, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you a blessed Eid during this coronavirus epidemic, and may he make it the best Eid ever for you and your family. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.